My name is Cleo. Those four words confirmed police had found little Cleo Smith alive 18 days after detectives say she was abducted from her family's tent at a remote campsite near Carnarvon. Step Form Gartle has been covering Cleo's disappearance since the four-year-old first went missing. Steph, this has been a remarkable day.
Nerelda, what a huge and unexpected result, a moment the entire nation was hoping for. Finding Cleo Smith alive, a testament to the town and the police who never stopped searching. Safe and in the arms of officers.
Cleo, my name's Cameron, how are you? Are you okay? We're going to take and see your mummy and daddy, okay?
Little Cleo Smith rescued 18 days after police say she was snatched in a brazen abduction from her family's tent at the Quobba Blowholes near Carnarvon.
She's alive, she's safe, and she's back with mum and dad.
Just four little words ended the desperate search that gripped the nation.
She looked at me and she said, "My name's Cleo."
It is a really special day for Western Australia. Indeed, I know the nation is rejoicing over the fact that we've been able to conduct this operation and we never gave up hope.
The breakthrough, an overnight raid. Police swarmed a property in the family's hometown of Carnarvon and say they found the four-year-old inside a locked bedroom.
People were in tears. It's fair to say it was just an amazing outcome.
Her disappearance captured international headlines. The police investigation, one of the largest in WA history. For almost 3 weeks, officers have meticulously scoured the Carnarvon coast, conducted surveillance across the entire state. They've interviewed witnesses, locals, sexual predators in the area, and offered $1 million cash to anyone who could help find her.
To the people of Western Australia, you are our eyes and ears. You gave us lots of information. It's still coming in, and we appreciate what you've already provided for us and what is yet still to come.
It was the hard work of the team that did it, analysing all of that information, gathering it all, working through it and finding that needle in that haystack.
If you feel the need to thank God today, thank God for the Western Australian Police Force.
They put their heart and soul into it, and they used the best of technology, and they also used all of their instinct, and they didn't leave any stone unturned.
The hard work of officers leading to this, a beaming smile the whole nation has been waiting and hoping to see. None more so than her parents, Ellie and Jake.
Said, "We've got someone here that wants to speak to you." And it was, you know, a wonderful feeling to be able to make that call.
We took her to hospital, obviously, to make sure she's okay. She was reunited with her parents along the way, so happened pretty quickly, but look, it was fantastic.
The investigation isn't over. In fact, this is where the hard work begins, as detectives work to build a case against the accused abductor.
We will be working through this for the next week or two at least. There's much more work yet to be done.
But after almost 3 weeks, Cleo is home, and in the words of her mother, their family is whole again.